All right, so it's back to Ask Me Anything. This is part four of the last Ask Me Anything for this year. So these are the questions that I'll couple together and put it as in one video. Okay, timestamps are put down below. Just check which question appeals to you. And if I feel the video is going too long, then I'll split it into a different section. Okay, so this one is from Akshay Kumar. His question is, Loy, I wanted to ask this as a fan of yours, a harsh truth video and the rant ones. Appreciate all the efforts and especially keeping it real. Thanks, man. Disclaimer before I ask, by no means is this an attack meant to hurt you, push hidden agenda, anything close. Don't worry, you are not going to hurt me with your questions. Okay? So, I'm a grown-ass man. Okay, anyway. Question. Loy, have you wondered what your life would be if you weren't married? Would it be good or bad, better or worse? Once again, thanks for what you do. If it turns out to be a topic for another video, that's welcome as well. Okay. So, what would your life be if you weren't married? Would it be good, bad? Good, better or worse? Or now, if you're asking me this question for you to get married, it's just keep in mind that you are not me, I'm not you. Your wife will not be my wife, my kind of wife. You know, your environment will not be my kind of environment. So what I tell you now doesn't necessarily imply that you should get married or not married. Each one of us is unique, okay? Each one of our situations is unique. And there is no overlapping of this, okay? Maybe we might have few traits, but that doesn't mean our lives are going to be the same. No, so now coming in answer to your question, how would my life, this is me, my life be if I weren't married? See, I've been married, this is the fourth time, okay? The first time was obviously married a Gora chick. I was immature. She lured me in with a Gora passport concept. Okay, fine, fuck it. She turned out to be a fraud. Second one was listening to my mentor and believing that Jesus spoke to him and she was the one for me. And I listened to the elders, even though I knew for a fact she was not my type. Okay, she was a good girl, good family, but it was a disaster. Third one, I told you, I got married because the UAE laws at that time didn't allow couples to live in together. And there was an Arab guy from the police who saw us together and she was my best friend. I genuinely wanted to make it work. I'm being honest. I genuinely wanted to make it work. But at some point I realized I was just forcing myself. Okay. So these were the three marriages. Now, the real marriage was this one, where I really decided I wanted to make it work. And how I knew I really wanted to be married, the first thing I wanted was a baby. The first thing, I didn't want, you know, people when they get married, they say, enjoy life, you know, take your time. And then when you have enough money, I said, nothing doing, I'm 40. The numbers, if you calculate, when I'm 40, I give birth. By the time my kid is 20, I'll be 60. So I can't wait any longer. Okay, so I wanted a child between us. So it was obvious that it was going to be a closer bond. Now, has it been for the better? 100% yes. For me, a guy who was always jumping from one branch to another, taking crazy risks, not being stable, being, you know, crazy. It was just madness. I would say it helped me for the better. But you can also say that the reason why it worked is because of my age. I was at 40. I couldn't bodybuild anymore. I didn't want to sleep around with girls anymore. I was just tired of all this nonsense up and down. And I really wanted to settle down. So the timing was perfect. But I can tell you this much, had I got married to this girl in my 20s, it would have gone for a divorce. It would have gone for a toss. So the marriage didn't work out only because the girl was right. The marriage worked out because I was right. I was right with myself, my head, my craziness, my madness. So for me, my personality, given how hyper I am, given how crazy I am, given the fact that I have this ADHD nonsense, it has kept me grounded. And today, you could say that every single day I get up with the fear that, fuck, I have a, you know, I have a two mouths to feed. I need to take care of them. I have to take care of their future. If I'm not earning, who will be there? So that leaves me really afraid, scared, worried. And it kind of pushes me to work hard. Now, obviously, you know, if I was alone, I'd definitely want a companion. I would want to have sex. I would want to talk to someone, get romantic. Just be with someone. You know, you can't always be alone. So we have needs. So this gets fulfilled and now I don't need to go anywhere else. And on top of that, you could say that my wife is perfect for me. She is a very loving, very sweet, very humble. Yeah, there are a few imperfections here and there. But then again, I'm not perfect myself. So in answer to your question, with regards to has it been better? Oh, 100%. It has been for the better. It has made me a better individual. More stable. Focus is on more money. But like I always tell you, the drawbacks, it's a massive responsibility, it's a massive headache. And money, whew, I can't stress enough, money gets spent like crazy, man. You should not, marry if you don't have the capacity to make money. And one final thing which I would just like to end with is, remember this one, there are too many variables, okay, too many to consider. See, my wife doesn't go out. My wife doesn't check social. She's not crazy about social media. She doesn't keep friends. She doesn't smoke, doesn't drink. She's literally, I think, 16 years younger to me. That is, you know, kind of half my age. I was 40. She was in her 27, like that, you know. So, you know, all these factors have to come into consideration. I was 44, yeah, 44. 41, I think, yeah. So, and yes, her family, her upbringing was quite a proper, simple girl, you know. She doesn't spend money for anything. So, yin and yang. And her only focus is to just be at home. She wants to take care of me. She wants to take care of the baby. And she allows me to be obsessed about my brand. She doesn't demand anything. Whether it's sex, whether it is going out, whether it is shopping. This is a rare combination. So all I want to tell you is, with my answer, don't suddenly say, "Oh, I got married. Chal, he became a better guy. Even I'll marry." Take it from me. It's more complex than what it sounds. So I hope this answers your question. And if you are planning to get married, I would say get married only after 30, 35. Say 35. Get married after the age of 35. By that time, you would have done all your jing bang and I think you'll come to know what you really want. Ideal age, 40. But if you have to get married, 35 is better. Otherwise, remember, if you have unfulfilled desires and dreams and urges, complications will take place. Okay? Anyway, I hope this answers your question. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Okay, moving on to the next question.